Why is my outlook.com email suddenly full? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. I'm getting this request or this question fairly frequently of late in the past couple of months, and it's because Microsoft has been rolling out a change to the way they manage storage in outlook.com. Ultimately, the bottom line is that storage for attachments and inline images is now shared with your OneDrive account, which means in turn that it's subject to the storage limitations of your OneDrive account. For example, let's have a look right here at this email account. This is an Outlook.com account, and you can see right there front and center, your storage is full. You can't send or receive messages or upload files to OneDrive. And of course, there's manage storage and get storage. Now, the cynics among us might say that this is a ploy by Microsoft to encourage you to purchase more OneDrive storage. I can't say that I disagree. Normally, I'm fairly supportive of the kinds of things that they've been doing, but this one seems really underhanded for one really interesting and obvious way that I'll talk about in a moment. But the real question is, what happened? How did we get here? Well, if we take a look at this specific email account, I've only got like what, maybe a dozen messages at most. And while some of them definitely have attachments, there isn't really that much data associated with them. The problem is the OneDrive account. Now, if we click on manage storage, or if we click on this 5 gigabytes used of 5 gigabytes, which is the free amount of space you get in OneDrive, if you're using a free account, I'll click on that. Now, there are two things you need to be aware of. One is Microsoft storage. Ultimately, that is OneDrive. And you can say that OneDrive is maxed out at just over 5 gigabytes. I have more than 5 gigabytes of information in my OneDrive. But do I? Well, take a look also at email storage. Now, you have 15 gigabytes of free email storage, and honestly, I've got less than 100 megabytes of email storage. The issue is that of that 100 megabytes, a good portion of it is attachments. And attachments now count against your OneDrive disk usage. So even though I've got 15 gigabytes of space, so-called, in my Outlook.com account, the reality is I've only got 5 gigabytes of space for attachments, for pictures that happen to be stored in email, and any OneDrive files that I happen to have. Now, here's the scenario where this really catches people by surprise. In the past, OneDrive and Outlook.com were completely separate. There was no relationship between their storage. You had 15 gigabytes in Outlook.com, you had 5 gigabytes in OneDrive. Didn't matter what you kept where, as long as you were under those limitations. The change is that they now share storage, at least at the quota level. Now, let's have a look at, say, an average Outlook.com account. Say you've got 10 gigabytes of email. You actually have been using it. You've accumulated a fair amount of email over time. Let's say also that a lot of that email has attachments. You've got documents, you've got PDFs, you've got who knows, whatever, stored in your email as attachments to the messages you've received. Those attachments, maybe they accumulate and exceed, say, 7 gigabytes in space. In the past, that was no issue. You were well within your 15 gigabytes of Outlook.com space. But now, those attachments and any pictures in email account against whatever your OneDrive limit is. So if your OneDrive limit is 5 gigabytes, as it is with a free email account, then as soon as Microsoft rolled out this change to your account, boom, you are out of space. And as we saw in that first message, you can't send any more email. You can't receive any more email until this problem is rectified. Now, there are two ways to deal with this problem. One is to start deleting email that has attachments. Everybody wants to delete just the attachments. Say maybe download the attachments, put them in a safe place, and then delete the attachment from the email leaving the body of the email in place. Unfortunately, the Outlook.com user interface doesn't let you do that. There's no way built in to make that happen. I've got a future video coming up where I've got a fairly cumbersome workaround that will let you solve the problem that way. But we're sticking to Outlook.com and OneDrive.com right now. That is not something you can do. The only thing you can do is literally delete the emails that have attachments until you get it down under the limit of your OneDrive account. The other approach, of course, is to go over to OneDrive, where you're also getting a message that you've exceeded your limit, and go into maybe one of the folders that has a bunch of these files and start deleting them. Here you can see I've actually got a 4.8 gigabyte file. I could delete that and poof, we're done. Now, what I'm hearing from a lot of people is that they don't realize that they're using OneDrive at all, which is very, very common. The problem is that when you accept all of OneDrive's defaults, when you're setting up a computer or just when you're setting up OneDrive, it is enabling backup of a bunch of folders on your system that you may not even realize are being backed up. Those are getting uploaded to your OneDrive, and sure enough, they're all counting against whatever the size of your OneDrive account happens to be. That can catch many people by surprise. I've got an article on that, how you probably want to turn that off so that it's not bumping you up against your OneDrive storage limit. But now that with email attachments also being included in this 5 gigabytes free, yeah, it's very common to run into this. So the other solution then, as I said, is to start deleting files from your OneDrive. Between that and your email, you should be able to get enough room to start using your system once again. Now, one of the other solutions that unfortunately doesn't work because it puts you in a chicken and egg situation is, remember that back here in Outlook.com, it says you can't send or receive messages. What seems like it would be a nice thing to do would be to say, take one of these messages that has an attachment, forward it to another account before you delete it from this one. You can't, because you can't send messages. It's a catch-22 situation. You want to forward it on to a different account so you can free up the space, but because you don't have any space, you're not allowed to forward it anywhere. It's a pain. So, what should you do? Honestly, bottom line, you probably need your Microsoft account for your PC or for other things that you happen to be doing. Honestly, if you find yourself in this situation, especially if you're using OneDrive, it's time to consider using a different account, in my opinion. It's time to consider using a different account for your email, an account that has a clear and significantly less confusing definition of what their limits really are. This is, without a doubt, one of the most confusing combinations of limitations that I've seen in a long time. Alternately, the first alternative, start deleting stuff. Delete either emails from your Outlook.com account that have large attachments, or start deleting files from your OneDrive account. Alternative number two, and this is the one I'm reluctant to suggest because ultimately by doing so, I'm kind of giving in to Microsoft's strong arm tactics, but you could purchase more OneDrive space. If you decide you want to do that, I'm going to recommend that you do so by instead subscribing to Microsoft 365. Currently $100 a year, but you get a terabyte of OneDrive space as part of that package. Honestly, even if you completely ignore the rest of the things that come with that package, and there's a lot, Microsoft Office and a bunch of other things, even if you ignore all of that, that's actually not a bad price for a terabyte of online cloud storage. However, that does kind of, sort of, let Microsoft win, and that's something that honestly really rubs me the wrong way. So I hope that helps you understand exactly what's happened and gives you a couple of ideas on what you can do. In an upcoming video, I'll talk about what it takes to actually delete attachments, but not the body of email. It's not pretty, but it is possible. It's just fairly cumbersome. For comments, for updates, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/156094. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.